Welcome everyone to Race to IAS Current Affairs Guru, a weekly program where we will be discussing the important current events of the past week. This will be a weekly program and we will be meeting once in every week. So how are you guys doing? How's your vacation plans coming along? I'm sure all of you must have had big plans for the vacation, but all of that might have got cancelled due to the peculiar situation prevailing in the country as well as all over the world. But don't worry, we hope that everything will be over soon and you guys can enjoy your vacation as usual. So while you are indoors, let's discuss some interesting events that has happened over the past week. Okay. The first one is regarding the ExoMars project. The launch of ExoMars rover has been delayed to 2022 due to parachute and electronics issues. You can see the picture of the rover here. So what is ExoMars? It is a joint endeavor between European Space Agency and Roscosmos. They are just like our ISRO. ISRO takes care of the space exploration programs of India, right? Similarly, European Space Agency takes care of the space exploration programs of European Union, and Roscosmos takes care of the space exploration programs of Russia. So the primary goal of ExoMars is to address the question of whether life has ever existed on Mars. So what is a rover? What is the difference between a lander and rover? The lander is that vehicle which carries all the equipments, including the rover, on the surface of Mars. Rover is just like a small robot with wheels that can be controlled by scientists on Earth. It will explore Mars, collect samples, and send this information back to the scientists. So that's all about ExoMars project. The next one is regarding WHO guidelines in fighting COVID-19. It has advised to use soap to effectively fight against COVID. So what is COVID or coronavirus disease? We see a lot of news in the media these days because of COVID-19. And the WHO has advised to use soap to effectively fight against COVID-19. Now, why is soap such much effective against the virus? All of you might have seen the picture of coronavirus, right? That round or spherical thing. It has a protective covering made up of a substance called a lipid, very similar to oil. Now, soap molecules are formed like this. You can see it in the picture, having a head and a tail. You see near to the picture of the head. The soap molecules are formed like having a head and a tail. The tail of the soap molecule has a high attraction to the lipid protective covering of the virus. So when we apply soap, what happens is that the tail of the soap molecules get attached to the lipid covering and pulls it apart, thus breaking and killing the virus. That's why WHO says that everyone should be using the soap to prevent the spread of the virus. Okay, understand. So this is a detailed account of what we have been explaining now. Those who want can pause the video and read about the mechanism. So moving on. Next news is that Prime Minister Modi has proposed an emergency COVID-19 fund for SAARC nations. So what are SAARC nations, or South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation Nations? It is a grouping of 8 nations of South Asia. Our PM has proposed that let's make a common fund for all SAARC nations to fight against coronavirus, and he has promised $10 million into this fund. We should wait to see how much will other countries also contribute. As you can see, these are the 8 countries that make up the SAARC nations, all of which are situated in the South Asian region of the globe. Next is regarding the Grand Ethiopian Renaissance Dam, situated in the African country of Ethiopia. Ethiopia is situated on the Horn of Africa, as you can observe in a map. The issue here is that Ethiopia is building a huge dam named Grand Ethiopian Renaissance Dam on the Nile River at Benishangul or Gurmuz region of Ethiopia. But Egypt, located downstream of Nile River, fears that constructing such a big dam near the mouth of Nile River will affect the amount of water they are getting from the river. After all, we all know that Egypt is called a gift of Nile, right? It shows how important Nile is for Egypt. So there occurred a dispute between Egypt and Ethiopia, with Sudan caught in between. The difference between these three countries became severe when Ethiopia recently skipped the latest round of tripartite negotiation with Egypt and Sudan in Washington, which was being mediated by United States and the World Bank. Why is it called a tripartite negotiation? Because it involves three parties. Which are the three parties? Ethiopia, Sudan, and Egypt. You can see the Grand Ethiopian Renaissance Dam, the location of the GERD in this map, and the three nations, Ethiopia, Sudan and Egypt in this map. Then River Nile flows through Ethiopia, Sudan and Egypt and drains into the Mediterranean Sea. You can see all these in this map. Okay. Next is regarding barrel stage emission standards. What are barrel stage emission standards? They are certain standards that vehicle manufacturers must follow while making the vehicle. Why? To reduce air pollution. We know that the vehicle exhaust causes a lot of air pollution, right? So government has devised some standards such as barrel stage emission standards for these manufacturers, where they have to include technologies that reduce air pollution by their vehicles. We have been following BS4 until now, but we have decided to switch over to stricter BS6 standards from April 2020 onwards. And here in this new stipend, Society for Indian Automobile Manufacturers has said that it has approached the Supreme Court seeking directions to ensure that the sale and registration of BS4 compliant vehicles is allowed till March 31, 2020. And the very next day onwards, BS6 standards vehicles will be started rolling out in our country. So about barrel stage emission standards, it was introduced in the year 2000. And they are being set by the Central Pollution Control Board, CPC, Central Pollution Control Board or CPCB under the Ministry of Environment and Climate Change. And the objective of the CPCB, of BSES is to keep air pollutants emitted by the internal combustion engines of vehicles under control. And they are based on European emission standards or Euro standards. Then how does BS6 emissions norms differ from BS4 emissions? There are five main differences regarding the diesel particulate filter and real driving emission standards, onboard diagnostic devices, sulfur and nitrogen oxide content, and the particulate matter or PM content in diesel cars in BS4 and BS6 vehicles. That is being detailed given in this slide, and those who want can pause and read it. Next is regarding permanent commission for women in Indian Navy. So there are mainly two types of service terms in India's defense forces, which are called a short service commission or SSC and a permanent commission. A short service commission is currently for 10 years and can be extended by 4 more years or a total of 14 years. A permanent commission entitles an officer to serve in this force until he or she retires. Now both short service commission and permanent commission are available to male officers, but until now permanent commission was not made available to women. Now, in a recent judgment, the Supreme Court had upheld the right of serving short service commission women officers of the Navy to be granted permanent commission on a par with their male counterparts. So what are the implications of this judgment? Women naval officers will now be able to apply for permanent commission. All serving women short service commission officers in the at least 7 wings, including executive engineering, electrical education, law and logistics, will be eligible to apply for this permanent commission. So that are the implications of permanent commission for women in Indian Navy. So moving on. Next is regarding the plea or case against Ranjan Gogoi's nomination to Rajya Sabha. Now, who is Ranjan Gogoi? He was the former Chief Justice of India who retired last year. He was nominated to Rajya Sabha by the President, which caused a lot of opposition because judges accepting political posts is considered as an unethical practice, as judges are expected to be impartial in carrying out their judgments. So, a petition has been filed at the Supreme Court, where the petitioner said that former judges should be insulated from post-retirement allurements, as faith in judiciary will dry up if it is not being observed like that. So what are post-retirement allurements? The Rajya Sabha seats or Lok Sabha seats or office of profits being given by the ruling party to the retired judges. That is called a post-retirement allurements. So the petitioner says that if the judges are accepting post-retirement allurements, it will erode the faith in the judiciary by the people. So what is issue here? There is no law or constitutional provision that prohibits such a nomination. So the president can nominate if he wants a retired judge to Rajya Sabha or Lok Sabha, and there is no constitutional or legal prohibition regarding that. Still, it is not a common practice that a government nominates or appoints a former Supreme Court judge or even a High Court judge to some office within months of her or his retirement. So, what are the exceptions currently in place to ensure independence of the judiciary? Currently, the only bar imposed on a judge of the Supreme Court who has retired is that he shall not thereafter plead or act in any court or before any authority. The provisions doesn't say that the judge cannot be appointed as a member of Rajya Sabha or a member of Lok Sabha. So, it is a serious case affecting the impartiality of the or the independence of the judiciary. So, all of you guys know about the procedure of nomination to members of Rajya Sabha, right? It's under the Article 80 of the Constitution. And under this Article 80 of the Constitution, the President has the power to nominate at least 12 members to the Rajya Sabha. And Mr. Ranjan Gogoi is being nominated to Rajya Sabha under this Article 80 of the Constitution. So, moving on. Next is regarding Colbert methane. So, what is Colbert methane? It is a kind of natural gas which can be used as an efficient fuel. Usually, we extract natural gas from the empty spaces deep between underground rocks, etc. But unlike conventional natural gas, Colbert methane is not situated in the empty spaces between rocks, but they are found in coal deposits attached to the coal blocks by a process called adsorption. It is not absorption, but it is adsorption, A-D-S-O-R-P-T-I-O-N. Now, a recent study finds that India has the fifth largest coal reserves in the world and that it has rich Colbert methane deposits across 12 states, with the Gondwana sediments of eastern India holding the bulk. And also, the Damodar Coil Valley and the Son Valley are prospective areas for Colbert methane development. Okay. So, the next is regarding World Happiness Report. So, what is World Happiness Report? It is a report published by Sustainable Development Solutions Network of the United Nations. And it is a landmark survey of the state of global happiness. And it ranks 156 nations by how happy their citizens perceive themselves to be. So, it doesn't rank nations according to their wealth as the GDP or World Development Report does. Mm-hmm. What does World Development Report do? It ranks nations according to their wealth or GDP. But the World Happiness Report ranks 156 countries by how happy their citizens perceive themselves to be. So, according to World Happiness Report 2020, Finland is the world's happiest nation for the third year running. For the past 3 years consecutively, Finland has been the world's happiest nation. And where does India figure in this list? India is a meager 144th rank in this 156 country list. And it says that Indians are a very unhappy kind of people as per this report. Okay. So, moving on. The final news snippet is regarding the Break the Chain campaign of Government of Kerala, launched to prevent the spread of COVID-19. We saw how effective is washing with the soap in destroying the virus in the previous slide, right? So, the Government of Kerala launched Break the Chain campaign to bring awareness in COVID-19. The campaign aims to educate people about the importance of public and personal hygiene. Under the campaign, government has installed water taps at public spots such as entry and exit gates of railway stations with hand wash bottles. It also urges people to use hand sanitizers when they are outdoors, because when they are outdoors, they cannot carry soap water with them, right? So they are being used, urged by the government to use hand sanitizers when they are outdoors. And that's all for this week. Hope you have enjoyed this session. Do remember to hit the subscribe button of our channel to receive regular updates. Also, download our Junior IAS app from Play Store for daily current affairs, mock tests and quiz. So, we will meet again the next week. Until then, stay safe guys. Goodbye.